Just south of the friendly beaches of San Diego, California, lies the most demanding terrain known to mankind.
Every single time you cross the border, it's like rolling the dice in Vegas.
It's been a sure bet for more than a decade that if there is a race in Baja and Johnny Campbell is entered, then everyone else is racing for second place. This is the story of a boy who followed a personal calling and navigated his way to manhood to become a great champion who literally took the road less traveled. And from the beginning, Johnny had the heart of an explorer and a passion for anything with wheels.
As a young boy, I had a dream of riding racing motorcycles. And even when I was like 5 years old, I remember drawing a picture of a red motorcycle and saying, when I grow up, I want to be a motorcycle racer.
What I think really helped a lot to help Johnny get through his dad's passing was a combination of his faith and a loving girlfriend and a lot of loving friends and the racing focus, his passion for that.
I was introduced to Baja in about 1988 when I went down and rode this beach race in Rosarito.
Johnny's work ethic and raw talent, along with his winning spirit, began to get the youngster on the podium. There are a few glamorous roads to success in the motorcycle world, and Johnny was fortunate to be noticed by a person who would not only become a sponsor, but also a mentor in the fiercely competitive world of off-road racing. The course was set that led Johnny into the capable hands of off-road racing legend Bruce Ogilvy and American Honda, but only after he completed another calling, this time to the wedding chapel. Johnny had the speed and talent. The best school was quite simply to go race in every kind of long distance event he could find.
I was just hungry to win and just wanted to do it.
By the summer of 1997, Johnny had amassed a considerable list of accomplishments. However, one race still eluded him, and it was Johnny's time to step up and win the most famous off-road endurance race on the planet, the Baja 1000.
If the green flag drops and you race until you get the checkered flag, it's the longest, oldest off-road race in the world. 75 or 80 miles an hour, it was normal for me to be on a dirt road going 100.
This is 10,000 miles of racing, if you think about that. You can't even imagine, for one, riding that far, and for two, racing that far, and for three, winning that much.
For someone to put themselves in a position to win 11 times, I mean, he walks the walk with guys like Larry Rossler and Johnny Johnson, Ivan Stewart.
That shows a lot of what Johnny's made of. That shows a lot of what the team's made of, a lot of the group of guys. I mean, that's a huge effort. The Baja 1000 is a huge undertaking, and to get 11 out of 12 years is impressive, and I mean, nobody can do that.
He's riding a history that's really hard to compare. I mean, when you look at the legends of the Indy 500, has anybody won 11 of them? No. And now as a team owner, I mean, he's already showed that he can take on the toughest competition and win.
You know, he's a superstar of off-road. He's the king of Baja.
He's the king of Baja, and he always will be.
Johnny's the legend of Baja. You know, he's El Campeón.
It just feels really good to be able to do something that's, you know, from the heart. You know that, you know, you don't want to, you know, you're not doing it for recognition, you're not doing it for, you know, your personal benefit, but really benefiting those in need.
I just want to thank everybody for coming and supporting the cause.
of Rancho Santa Marta.
Being a true champion, exactly what he is. Good guy and a badass on a bike. Overall, God's had so much grace and blessed me with so much, you know, it's just kind of icing on the cake that I've been able to do this as long as I have and stay free of injury and be as successful as I am. So I just give God all the glory for my whole career.